I'm Hudson.
We're Trail Boots. We run the rock band from New Jersey.
Background with like learning stuff is my dad's a musical theater actor and singer guy, so I've sort of been around music my whole life. Then when I was around 5 or 6, I started taking piano lessons, and then sort of built off of that. When I was 9, I really wanted to start playing guitar, so I did that and sort of built off of that into most string instruments, and then playing for school and stuff. So now I play 9 and and I take lessons at So I Heard Music, where we actually met over the summer 2 years ago.
I started playing guitar about, 9 years ago, I think. I've lost count, honestly. But I remember listening to Mastodon one night. I think it was Blood and Thunder. And I was like, I want to be able to play that in 4 years. And I just kind of, I'm sort of always around guitars. Like, my dad always had one somewhere. He never really played with him. It was always one somewhere, I remember. So I started taking lessons when I was about 6, I think, and I've just sort of been playing a lot since then. And then ever since then, before we met, I was just kind of that kid who just played Iron Maiden covers in his room, and I never jammed with anybody else or done anything else. And then we met at this music camp, and I showed him Tenacious D covers, and then we started doing musical stuff,
yeah.
And that turned into this. There's one band out there that we're kind of inspired by, I think without them, Unlocking the Truth, if you've ever heard of them. They're like 14, 15 years old, and they played like their first song, and they played at Coachella and stuff. They have like 3 songs, but everybody was like, oh my god, they're teenagers and they can play pretty solid music, you know, they're cool. I like them, but I feel like using age as an excuse isn't something that we want to do. Like, I think that we have, sort of as the youngest kids, the responsibility to show that we're no different than anybody else. Like, we should get up there and be the same thing as, you know, 20-year-olds.
Yeah, that's sort of our goal.
Yeah, it's just,
break down that sort of age barrier in a lot of people's minds, on top of making good music.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of people who shove the idea of a younger band out of their heads because they're a younger band. And people think that their music wouldn't be as developed, which is true in a lot of cases, because they're influenced on a lot of things and they're not creating their own influences.
But not in ours.
Yeah, in our case, we're constantly trying to build up a new sound, and even though people push that aside.
Desert Rock specifically, it started out in Palm Desert, California, and it was like a group of bands there, and they took like the doom metal sound that like Black Sabbath and stuff was doing, and then they just did it in California, and it's called Desert Rock because they had no venues to play, because it was the middle of like a wasteland town in California, where are you going to go? So they would take gas generators and actually go out into the middle of the desert and play these huge concerts there. And I got obsessed with it as we were making this band, so that's sort of where the whole idea came from.
Yeah.
So Desert Rock is really that sort of doom metal-y, hard rock psychedelic sound that comes from Palm Desert specifically, because a lot of our songs are based off of those specific bands, but I think we do have influences. Like, I think lyrically we're most influenced by like Electric Wizard, and they're from like England, they still have that same sort of sound.
Yeah,
so
we've been recording things, writing for like a long time, but playing out for the first time, like as a group.
Yeah, I wrote and recorded the whole first album, and I wrote and recorded it to be meant to be played live, and I just wanted the chance to actually put it out there and show people what it actually meant to sound like, because I feel like recorded, you can't really get everything, but live, the album is meant to be played live. Like,
the emotion is different live.
It's supposed to be live.
Yeah.
So finally being able to do that was just, I've been thinking about that for so long, so it's the greatest thing ever.
Check us out on Bandcamp and SoundCloud.
TrailDriftingQuiz.tk is the website.
That's the website.
First, Ulrich Geiss? I don't know how to pronounce his last name. Ulrich somebody. Guitar Ingenuity YouTube tutorials. I would not be playing guitar nearly as good as I would be without him. I'm sorry that I don't know how to pronounce his last name, but he did an album for us, because I emailed him, like, and it was amazing, because it was, like, all the stuff that I wanted to hear so, so badly. Henry Menzel from The Locker is awesome. Brian.
And our parents. Our parents.
One parent of mine, my dad.
Yeah, and my parents.
Whoever Brian is, the guy who runs the Tiki Lounge in New Brunswick, thank you very much, whoever listens to our album, for not listening to Electric Wizard instead, because I would rather go listen to Electric Wizard than my own album, so, and you probably should too, because Wizard is awesome, but whatever, thank you.